today I wanted to explore core beliefs and core wounding and how to be with core beliefs. So, core beliefs are universal. The psyche is built off of these conclusions we made as young ones. And usually they've been convinced, they've had ourselves convinced over and over in our nervous systems. They sound like, I'm not good enough. They sound like, I'm not worthy. I'm not lovable. I'm no good. I'm bad. And these things can be patterned into our nervous system. They're feelings. They're feelings that get interpreted by the head as, I'm bad, I'm banishable, I got left, I'm worthless, I'm useless, I'm behind. Even if the external world is presenting information that verifies your core belief, core beliefs are falsehoods. They're unhelpful. And they don't help anybody come out of, my tummy. They don't help anybody come out of the belief to keep hammering on ourselves to be convinced there. It doesn't help one change the pattern that's happening in the world to keep believing in a core belief. It doesn't help shift it. Like, if you believe you're not good enough and you keep not getting jobs and not getting the girl, and it doesn't actually help to keep your core belief. So, if you can find something like, I'm bad, I'm wrong, I'm unworthy, I'm lame, I'm boring, in the body, and welcome it here. What does it feel like to feel, I'm bad? Where is it in the body? Might just start as like a sinking feeling or something more ephemeral. But these places deserve to be blessed in our meditation spaces. So I'm just completely welcoming the bad one, the one that's convinced they're not lovable, whatever it is for you. And just pick one. And really let that part be here in your body. Almost like it's going to inhabit your body and sit inside of you as you. You can let it look out of your eyes. can let it breathe your breaths. Let it look around the room. Let it inhabit your whole body. We're just going to be so sweet with it. No trying to figure it out or convincing it it's lovable or changing its opinion of itself. Just gets to sit here somatically in the body. The more you're in touch with the feeling, the better. Really allowing the heaviness or the contraction or the dark. Have some attention here. The more and more these places are accompanied, the more you realize their nature. They have the same nature as everything else. Love. Being. They're just a distortion. Like a mirage. The more that they're felt consciously, not just running your subconscious, but felt consciously, the more you get familiar with the sensations, the conclusions, and how you behave out of it, like consuming, alcohol or drugs, or going to places that aren't safe, or hanging out with people that don't treat you well, or the whole gamut of things that reconfirm your unworthiness. Just letting it be here has a certain sense of blessing to it. So you're just going to sit as that unlovable one and show it that it's worthy of a whole meditation, a whole bunch of time and space and attention, like a whole bunch of it. Welcome its cousin, hopelessness. Just let the hopelessness be here too. Let the divine decide who you are. Let the light that's here that you are, that surrounds you, let it tell you about this part. Is it bad as you say? Is that what God sees? Is that what space sees? Does it see bad? Or Or is it just silent, steady presence? These sensations are kind of like who we think we are, like the shape of it in your body in this moment. It's like, yeah, that's me. And just really notice that that's the mind story. But without that, it's just a feeling. Like, what is the feeling of bad feel like? Is it tight? Is it warm? Is it heavy? Does it make your body sink? And what's it longing for? Let it long for love. For presence, for being seen, for redemption. Let it in. Let the light in. Let the love in. And the trick is, these places give us a real look at what our agenda is. That we're not so unconditional. That we'd rather have these places go away. Get the hell out of here. And they won't settle for anything less than love itself. So it can really tutor the whole nervous system into a full stop, like a full stop for the bad one, full stop for the unworthy, the feeling of unworthy, the feeling of the bad one. The light wants to go all the way down. That's where we really have a freedom, like a release of the whole system. And we find these places as beloved, as the beloved, not as the bad or the banished. And we can't just think that, we have to know it from the inside out. Just like keep revealing, keep coming out of the shadows. It's like true shadow work. feel it in every crevice of your body. Like, feel how it contracts in your lower back, or wraps around your back, upper back, or digs into your heart. Feel how it collapses your stomach or your solar plexus, or makes your legs feel weak. Like, really get a sense of letting it be here fully. Whatever this place is that you're convinced of, let it have some sunlight, some consciousness, and some God. If it doesn't have words, just let yourself feel the ugh. There are guests, no agenda. There are beloved guests. Like, the wonderful thing about these places is that once you've seen to the bottom of many of these places, you start developing a trust, and it reframes your whole identity from this sludge. And it reframes your whole visual seeing of others. Like, when you see one that looks out of their eyes with, I'm bad, you see the beloved, you see the truth of who they are. You don't join the party, the dream. You really have to be courageous not to know what these parts are. Like, not to know and to let that be God's business. Like, I don't know what this is. I don't know what this is. It's been here my whole life. Or since I was 9, or whatever it is. It's like, man, I don't know what to do with this. You tell me, God, what is this? I think I'm bad, but I'm willing to not know, because I really don't have a clue. I actually don't know that I'm bad. I actually don't know that with certainty. I don't. Let's see what happens there. That's really letting it be God's business, or being, or whatever you call it, truth, love. It's love's business who you are, not yours. And really notice that the if you're letting the bad one breathe, like letting it breathe your breath, letting it feel your whole body, letting it take up the room. Notice that it's not being poked or banished or pushed aside. And it's being given 100% oxygen. These places strengthen us. They let us feel love and all the way in the dark. They let us feel the truth of being in the dark. And let the dark and the light merge. Where there's no duality. Nothing left out, nothing separate, nothing banished. Letting yourself spread out. Finally be here. Join the living. like all the way human, all the way human. Landed, landed on earth. Coming all the way into the body, letting the soul, the being, embody the whole thing. Let it not be scared of the bad one or the banished one or the not good enough. Let it just swallow them whole, befriend them, beloved, precious parts. Beloved, precious, confused conclusions. I'm gonna sing for one more minute. And you can imagine everything, 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 everything that's here being what I'm talking about. All is God. There is only God. All is God. There is only God. All is light. There is only light. Even the dark. All is light. There is only light. All is love. There is only love. All is love. There is only love. Even in hate. Me. Bob Marley's phrase, emancipate yourself from mental slavery. Just came like that. That cage that creates conclusions about the sensations that we have just isn't true. They're just sensations, nervous system stuff. Yay. Take care. Yay.